Welcome back to Andrea Jean Cleaning. Today I'm going to show you how to easily keep your washing machine smelling fresh, especially if you have a front loader like this one right here. A lot of gunk and smell can get trapped up inside here. Now, this washing machine is really awesome. This is my mom's. She takes excellent care of it and it looks like brand new. This is what she does to help it keep it smelling fresh longer and stronger because these front loaders are known for stank and stench. Every time you wash your laundry, let's say you did a whole day's worth of laundry, what you want to do is grab yourself a towel of some sort that you use for this. And you want to make sure that you're wiping down in between these flaps right here. There's two, one here that goes all the way around, and then one back in here that also goes all the way around. So moisture can get trapped in there, and then mold and mildew builds up, and that's why you got the stinky smell. And then once it builds up, it's really hard to get that smell out of there. So if you can keep up with it, after I show you a little trick here, that's what you want to be doing. Wipe it down. It takes you like 2 seconds to get in here with your towel, go all the way around the perimeter of it in there. This washing machine is really nice because there's also, let me just pull this out here, a tiny little wash here. So if you had some delicates, or maybe you only wanted to wash one or two things, but again, you're going to want to wipe it down when you're done with your wash cycle and then leave the doors open. My mom always leaves these cracked, and I have a top loader washing machine, and I always leave my lid open as well so that it can ventilate. You don't want any moisture trapped up in there. Okay, here's a tip and trick. If you find that you have a super smelly washing machine that you cannot get the smell out of, this is also going to fluffen up your laundry, which is really nice too. In here, this is where my mom's is, there's a little section for bleach. What I recommend doing, and I do this in my top loader as well, is I take about a cup of vinegar and I put it in this bleach cycle right here. And that's going to help kill any bacteria and deodorize what's living inside this washing machine. And also, because vinegar is acidic, when your towels start to get kind of mildewy smell and kind of that crunchy, non-soft texture, the vinegar will help soften all of those things up. This is what I want you to do next. Grab yourself an old toothbrush. I know sometimes you go to the dentist and they give you a bunch of extra toothbrushes. Have this on hand. And then I just have a spray bottle here of some vinegar. If you don't want to use vinegar, you don't have to use vinegar. You could use anything that you wanted. You could use bleach if you preferred to use that. You could use baking soda and some water. You could use rubbing alcohol because that kills bacteria. I wouldn't mix them, that's for sure, but I would just choose something that you like. You could use citric acid mixed with water, which is basically dried up lemons, essentially, to help deodorize and kill any of the bacteria that's living inside here. And the toothbrush is nice because you can really pull this back and scrub in there all around in this rubber sealant right here. And then I would also clean the inside with vinegar. Again, just get your spray bottle. You could let it sit for a couple minutes and then wipe it down. And then make sure that if you have any moisture left in here, that you dry it on up. This is super, super important. This is very similar to keeping your whites whiter longer. If you let your whites go too long, it's really hard to get them back to the original pristine white smell, just like this washing machine. If you let it get too stinky and too much bacteria building up, it's a much more difficult job for you to get it done. But go in there, give it a good scrub down with a little toothbrush, a little vinegar is what I prefer here. Wipe it down, keep your doors open, and that should help keep your front loader or your top loader smelling better for longer. Now, I have a whole video about how I did this with my top loader, so I will have that linked in the description box below, but I wanted to give you multiple examples. I do get a stinky smell in my top loader, and I don't have this rubber lining, but these are definitely known for that. That definitely maintains some of that moisture in these dark crevices right here. All right, if we are not friends on Instagram, make sure you come over and say hello at Andrea Jean Co. I teach women how to turn their passion into profit, and this cleaning channel is one way that I do that. Thumbs up, subscribe, and I will see you, my friend, in the next one.